Everyone loves data. I think we can all remember when we were kids and we'd spend all our free time putting together Excel spreadsheets for fun. Ah, those were the days. Oh, you didn't do that as a kid? That was just me? Okay. But still, data is super useful to businesses like yours. By looking at data reports about your website activity, for example, you can learn a lot about your audience, who they are, what they want, and how you can better market to them. That's exactly what Google Analytics lets you do. The most recent version of Google Analytics is GA4, and it has a slightly different array of reports than previous versions. In this video, we're going to give you an overview of those reports. Keep watching to learn more. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can find the majority of reports in GA4 in, you guessed it, the Reports tab. These non-custom reports are known as standard reports. The first type of standard reports in GA4 is real-time reports. These reports show you a live feed of what's happening on your website. You can then view other reports showing where those users are located, which channels they found your site through, which pages they're viewing, and more. Most of the standard reports are divided up between the four lifecycle stages: acquisition, engagement, monetization, and retention. First, we have acquisition reports. These reports focus on which channels help you get the most users and traffic. Within these reports, you can also see things like sessions, engagement rates, and more. There are three tabs in the acquisition section: acquisition overview, user acquisition, and traffic acquisition. Each of them have different charts and graphs, but they all serve the purpose of showing you which channels are driving leads and traffic to your website. After acquisition comes engagement. Engagement reports show you how users are behaving on your website. There are a few different types of engagement reports. You have an overview tab, and also tabs for events, conversions, pages and screens, and landing page. All of these reports help you view user activity and site interactions. Basically, they help you understand what people do once they've found your website. You can see how many people took a specific action, like viewing a page or promotion, as well as how many converted into leads or customers. This gives you an idea of how effective your web design and content is. The next stage of the lifecycle is monetization. Monetization reports are all about the sales and revenue you drive on your website. As you might expect, this type of report is most relevant if you have an online store. Not counting the overview page, there are four pages in this section: e-commerce purchases, in-app purchases, publisher ads, and user purchase journey. These pages let you see what products people are buying on your website and your mobile app, if you have one. You can also see the journey users take on your site before making a purchase. The last lifecycle stage is retention. This section lets you view metrics like user engagement and customer lifetime value. You can use it to see how successful you are at bringing users back to your site after their initial visit. In addition to the lifecycle reports, there are also user reports. One type of user report is a demographics report. Believe it or not, demographics reports are about user demographics. I know, shocking. You can view reports about your website visitors' age, gender, interests, and more. That helps you get a more complete picture of your audience so that you can more effectively market to them. The last type of standard reports is tech reports. These reports focus specifically on the technology people are using to visit your website. That means you can view data on the devices, browsers, and even screen resolutions that people are using. When you know that info, you can optimize your web design to better fit the tech your site visitors are using. So far, we've only talked about standard reports. But in GA4, there are also exploration reports, which Google just calls explorations. These reports are in a totally separate tab of analytics, below the Reports tab. So what exactly are exploration reports? Well, basically, they're a new type of GA4 reporting that goes beyond basic metrics and helps you uncover deeper and more niche insights about your audience. You can create several different types of exploration reports. For example, you can create tree graphs to map the journey that different users take on your site. Or you can create Venn diagrams to see which of your audience segments overlap with one another. There are several other options as well. Unlike with standard reports, Google doesn't automatically create these reports for you. You can set them up yourself by modifying pre-existing templates so they're more customized to fit exactly what you're looking for. It's really important to keep up with what's happening on your website, and GA4 reporting is one of the best ways to do that. No matter what kind of marketing analytics you're interested in learning more about, WebFX can help. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel or to our email newsletter to see more helpful marketing info. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.